Assalamu alaikum, guys. What is up? This is Sodom, aka We All Blessed. And for today, man, we're outside. You know, it's a good day. Actually, it's very cold. My brother's fasting as well. I'm fasting too. And Brother Albert is here with me again. As y'all know, Brother Albert from the other video. You know, Brother Albert, tell the people, man, what are we going to be talking about?
So for today, we are going to be talking about following girls on Instagram, following the opposite gender on Instagram or any type of social media, the impacts of it and why you shouldn't do it and the Islam's view on it. That's what we're going to talk about today.
So first of all, following girls on Instagram, bro, do you think that this should be done? And do you think, what are the consequences from doing this? Because, you know, a lot of guys, they follow a lot of girls, and a lot of these girls, they post a lot of different things, and they're posting whatever, you know, the duck face, you know, whatever their poses are. They're posting all this, and guys are always looking at this, they're getting their likes and everything. So what's your take on, you know, guys, multiple guys following all these girls, and, you know, shed some light, brother.
I feel like it's both ways, but this one thing needs to be made explicit and important. That the man in Islam, the man by Allah, was told to lower his gaze before the woman was told to cover up.
Yeah.
So it is the man's responsibility first that he lower his gaze and not use the woman as a scapegoat, right? Because you're going to have all different types of women, you know, posting different types of pictures and whatnot. And it doesn't matter if they're religious pictures or non-religious pictures.
Yeah, yeah.
Those are private pictures. You have no authority to look at them. You should not be able to look at them. You shouldn't look at them. And so, if you are not her mahram, if you're not her father, if you're not her brother, if you're not her husband, if you're not somebody of this nature, you have no authority to look at private photos like that. It doesn't matter if she's giving you permission. It doesn't matter if she says, you're like a brother to me. You are not. If you're not blood brother, that's it. You're not. So if you want to argue with that, you can talk to Allah about that when you see him on the Day of Judgment. But as for, we all know, he's put all the rulings clearly in the Quran and through hadith to the Prophet Muhammad. And so if you want to argue with it, that's just what it is. But everyone's doing it, and it's difficult. The main thing is that it's very difficult to go against such things, even these small things. They will be looked at as small and put aside, but they have a huge impact.
Yeah.
And they have a huge impact, and it's just not good for you.
It's not good for you. And bro, I want to tell you guys one more thing. That we talked about the Islamic side. Now also the psychological side, that you're following all these girls. I'm telling you, first of all, right now, you're not going to get any. You're not getting nothing. You're just in a delusion. Satan has you deluded that you think that you're going to get that girl, but you're really not. Because the same picture she's uploading, 100 other guys are looking at that. And people are just, you know, lusting over that stuff, and people are not, they're not serious about anything. And why be that number? Why be that stat? Why be that other like? Why be that other comment? Aren't you any greater? Don't you have some potential in you? Aren't you beautiful? This is sometimes you lowering yourself, you're bowing down indirectly without actually doing it. You're bowing down to these girls, lusting, marveling, you know, in just a state of awe. Wow. Bro, are you that low? Get up and do your thing, man. This thing is right here, is made to destroy you. It's gonna, if you fall into this, what happens is now you lose touch in all of your own personal life. You forget about your own self. Like, you liked working out, you liked doing these good things. Because of these things, it made you forget about everything. And now you lost your own identity. You forgot who you were. Right, Brother Albert? Do you think that this is very true? Like, people forget their own self. They forget about themselves. They forget about their own identity as the person they were.
You know, I think, to be honest, you're right on the money. You're right on the money. I think I've seen a lot of people that, you know, they come up in Muslim families, you know, but when they come in and they interact with society, which you cannot avoid, obviously you have to interact with society, but when you do, you come across this idea that, you know, these things aren't a problem. And so you begin, if you do not have a strong enough faith, you begin to integrate yourself within these ideas. And then before you know it, you've kind of lost your, you know, standing on faith. The reality is that this idea of following, you know, your opposite gender on social media, in particular, guys following the girls. You know, you're seeing her private pictures, but more importantly, let me tell you this. I'll say this first. When you're following other girls that you know or even don't know on Instagram or whatever, you have full access to message her privately. You're not allowed to do that. You should not be able to do that. And if you are allowing yourself to do that by adding her and having her on social media, then you're at fault, right? Even if she's giving you permission, you need to be strong enough within your heart to say, Allah would be displeased with me if I did this. So you have to cut off that communication. Also, let me be real here. On Instagram, guys are not simply following girls just to make friends. Sometimes guys like what they see. And so if you do not lower your gaze, as Allah has told you in the Quran many times, to lower your gaze, as the man was told to lower his gaze before the woman was told to cover up, that you do not lower your gaze because you are amused with what you like. And the, you know, women of in explicit pictures and whatnot, you need to be strong enough, and it is your responsibility that you cut that off. You unfollow it. If you can't do it, you get rid of your Insta account. You get rid of whatever. You need to do what is important. It's very important. You know, it's just what it is.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, this comes down to you. Your eyes are being messed up. Your soul is being messed up. You know what's the gateway to your heart, your soul? It's your eyes, what you look at. You looking at these things, my brother, my sister, is making you forget about your own self. It's making you forget about your own passion, your love, the things that you love to do. You know, and we as Muslims, man, what do we believe in? We believe in all of this to be a test. Satan has things deluded for you, meaning that you're looking at these things and you're just in I want that. But did you get it? Do you have that? No, you don't. And he's constantly making you waste your time. I'm telling you, time is important, man. My whole bottom line, I'm being a brother. He's being a brother. We took out our time just to do this. Why? For one brother out there that can listen to us and take motivation, that he goes today on his Instagram account, he said, you know, man, I'm tired of all this, man. You know what I'm gonna do right now? I'm gonna follow that girl. I'm gonna follow all of them. You know why? Because I love myself. I love Allah. I love this messenger. Why? I love myself, man. It's that love you have for yourself. But if you don't, and you want to be a dog and a sheep in a herd, then go follow him. Go lust over him. And I'm telling you right now, as a brother from another mother, you will never get any of them. Am I right, bro? Do you agree with that?
Right on the money, bro.
And bro, any passion and motivation to the brothers that are in this, man, just give them that motivation to stop following that, man. Get back on track. Your life is better, man.
I'll say one thing. I'll say this. Guys like acting like they're tough. And the idea of being tough is being integrated in society, getting the girls, going and drinking this, go smoke this. This is the idea of tough. This is not the idea of tough in Islam. The idea of tough in Islam is looking at all the lustfulness, all the delusion, all of, you know, this, even the slightest things like this, exactly, that you can easily fall into, looking at it and saying, nah, I fear Allah, and turning the other way. That's tough. Why? Because you barely see anyone doing that. No, if you want to be tough, if you want to be rough, if you want to pass the test of Allah, you need to be able to be strong even in the smallest things. Because the reality is, let me tell you, sin starts in the smallest things, and shaitan will take you slowly to the next level. It's okay, I'll do this more, and so on and so forth. Even for social media. So you may say, oh, I'll just add them, but I won't talk to them. Oh, I'll talk to them, but it's just, it's private. Oh, I'll just look at the pictures, but it's nothing. And you know, it goes on. You know what I'm talking about. It could go to dating. You have no idea.
So man, you know, and just as the brother said, and I said, we're not any better. You know, we're not any better. But we, as being as brothers to you, we felt like we should talk about this, because a lot of people won't talk about this. You know, this is a big problem. This is facade. This is corruption on earth. You know, obviously social media, but still on earth. And your souls are being gutted. So that's why we felt like we have to talk about this. And if we don't talk about this, God knows, we might not be strong either. So as a believer, when we also encouraged, you know, to stop the bad, it gives us our own selves motivation. That, yeah, man, let's do this. Let's not do this. Yeah? So I'm telling you, man, inshallah, I pray Allah makes it better. And inshallah, this is my brother Albert, man. May Allah bless him. We're going to be doing more things. You know, summer is here, man. Inshallah, if you guys have any recommendations, let us know. So remember, man, you bless, I bless, and we all bless.
Yo, actually, subscribe, check it out.